Okay, so let us go ahead and solve the maximum flow for this graph right here. And again, I've got nodes. I've got a source node. No in nodes, in edges allowed on that. I've got a sink node. No out edges allowed on that. And I've labeled my edges with a maximum capacity. And what I want to find out is, what is the maximum flow that can be placed on these edges so that I can get the maximum flow through the entire network. Okay, so to do this algorithm, the first thing you do is you assign an actual flow of 0 to all of our edges. And I'm going to indicate that like so. Okay, and then from this flow network right here, I compute the residual graph. Okay, so the residual graph has the same nodes. And then when I'm computing my direction, I have to see how much I can still push forward and how much I can undo. In this case, I can push everything forward, and you can see that because I haven't actually assigned anything. So I can just push everything forward of my capacities. That's the amount of capacity I can have on each of these edges. Okay, the next step is to take our residual graph right here and find what's called an augmenting path. And this augmenting path has to go from S to T. And so, and I'm following along the direction of these edges. So let us take, for example, U, V, T. Okay, S to U to V to T. Okay, next step, for that's our path. Next step is to find the bottleneck of that path. And the bottleneck of that path is the edge with the minimum capacity. So 20, 30, 20, the minimum equals 20. Okay, now I take that 20 right there that I got from the bottleneck, and I push actual flow of 20 units onto all of the corresponding edges. Okay, so here's my new flow network right here. Okay, so 20 is what I pushed through there, so that'd be 20 out of 20. And then I can have 20 going down here, so that's 20 out of 30. And then 20 here, so that's 20 out of 20. And then the rest of my flows, my actuals and my capacities are unchanged. 0 out of 10 for there and 0 out of 10 for there. Okay, 0 out of 10. Okay, now the next step is to repeat this process using this as my new graph right here. So I am going to go through and erase what I have here and move this G up so that we can see it. Okay, so I have moved my original graph up there with the augmenting path being used to change the actual flows. I need to compute my residual graph from this flow network right here. So here are my nodes, the same as from my graph. Okay, now in this, from S to U, I've got no more capacity to push forward, but I can undo 20 units. From U to T, I can push forward 10 units. There's nothing I can undo. From V to T, nothing I can push forward, but I can undo 20 units. From S to V, I can push forward 10 units. From U to V, I can push forward 10 units, and I can push back 20 units. Okay, the next step is to find an augmenting path from S to T. So I could go S, V, U, T, like so, S, V, U, T. You find the augmenting path on the residual graph. Look at my bottleneck. So it's 10, 20, 10, so the bottleneck will be 10. And so that 10 tells us how to modify my flows up here on this exact path so that on this exact SVUT so that I can continue and compute my maximum flow. So let me do a quick redraw of my G so that we can see how these actual flows are being modified. Okay, between S and U, there is no change because that is not on the current augmenting path. Between S and V, we see I can put 10 units. That's my bottleneck, so that's 10 units I do put on that edge. That is out of a capacity of 10, so that's 10 out of 10 that I have right there. From V to U, I have here a backwards edge. So what I want to do for this backwards edge right here so from V to U, I have a backwards edge of 20 units that I can undo. My bottleneck is 10, so that means I'll have I want to undo 10 units of what's going forward here. Okay, so that means this forward edge right here, I actually want to push back 10 of those. So that makes 10. 20 minus 10 gives us 10 out of 30. Did you see that? I'm following this path right here. Bottleneck is 10, so I want to go push back 10 units of this edge right here. So I have 20 going forward. I want to push back 10. 20 minus 10 is 10. So that's what I've got right here. Going from here to here, I want to add 10 units to that. So that's 10 units actual flow out of 10. And then there I'm done. This last edge right here, V to T, there's been no change on that. 20 out of 20. Okay, so from this right here, Let's first pause for a second and make sure I still have an okay graph. None of my actual flows exceed my capacities. Let's check conservation. Coming into U, I have 20. Going out of U, I have 10 plus 10. That's okay. Coming into V, I have 10 plus 10. That makes 20. Going out of V, I have 20. So that's okay. Let's compute our residual graph for this G right here. Okay, so I have S, U, V, and T. Here, I can undo 20. U to T, I can undo 10. S to V, I can undo 10. We actually don't have to continue now because we can see there's no way I can get an augmenting path, but let's go ahead and complete it. From U to V, I can push forward 20. And I can undo 10 from V to U, so 10. From V to T, I can undo 10, so that's a undo 20. That's a backward edge of 20. Augmenting path from S to T, no. So since there's no S to T path, there's no way I can get from S to T, I am done. And right here, this is my graph with maximum flow. I've got 30 coming out of S, 30 going into T.